Hello everyone and welcome to the channel or welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to talk about the divorce rate has doubled since 1990 for Americans over 55. For couples over 65, the rate has tripled. And in financial terms, few gray divorcees are better off. Gray divorce has surged in recent decades, even as the divorce rate for younger Americans has declined. 1 in 10 people getting divorced today is 65 or older. So let's talk about it, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment, like, and share the video. It's free. Breaking up in old age can be costly, especially for women. During her long marriage, Brenda, 82, says she paid absolutely no attention to family finances. The former real estate agent left all the details to her husband, even in the years after he retired, when she was still working. So when she asked for a divorce 12 days before their 56th anniversary, she was unprepared for what came next, a settlement process that, she says, left her with much less than she thought was fair. Brenda blames herself, she says, for not knowing enough about her finances or divorce law and then rushing to complete the painful and costly process. Divorce, at any age, comes with emotional costs. But, as Brenda learned the hard way, a so-called gray divorce, a marital breakup after age 50, can also cost a lot of money, as years or decades of interrelated finances and acquired assets typically require extensive work to sort out. Divorce is definitely a financial hit for almost everyone, and older couples face some extra challenges. The costs can be especially steep, experts say, for people who go into the process with too little information or planning. The rate of gray divorce, a term that describes divorce at age 50 and older, doubled from 1990 to 2019, according to a 2022 study published in the Journals of Gerontology. It tripled for adults over age 65. In 1970, about 8% of Americans who divorced were age 50 and older. By 2019, that share had jumped to an astounding 36%. About 1 in 10 people, which is 9%, who divorced in 2019 were at least 65 years old. Meanwhile, rates of divorce have declined among younger adults. The chronic economic strain of gray divorce typically has more negative implications for women than for men, said Camilla Elliott, a certified financial planner and co-founder of Collective Wealth Partners based in Atlanta. Studies suggest women's household income generally drops between 23% and 40% in the year after a divorce. The economic effects are less severe for men, with some studies showing their income may even rise after a breakup, according to Laura Tack and Alicia Eid, sociology professors at Cornell University and the University of Toronto, respectively. The duo have co-authored several papers on the topic. Those financial disparities seem to be more muted for younger generations of women due to a greater likelihood of them working relative to older cohorts, experts said. Many older adults who divorce today adhere to the tradition of a man as a household's sole breadwinner. They are seeing women in divorce today who are of the generation where they just didn't work their entire life, said Natalie Colley, a CFP based in New York and senior lead advisor at Francis Financial. Women also tend to earn lower incomes than men because of their career choices. They tend to have less savings, and near retirees who are divorcing don't have much time to make up the difference. Divorced women can claim a Social Security benefit based on their own earnings or a former spouse's earnings history, but the latter option is generally worth only up to half of an ex's benefit. Remarrying or cohabitating generally helps bolster one's finances via pooling of resources. But women who undergo gray divorce are less likely to do so than men. Only 22% of women remarry in the decade after gray divorce versus 37% of men, putting them at sustained economic disadvantage into old age. Altogether, women's standard of living declined by 45% following a gray divorce, while the drop for men was less severe at 21%. These negative economic outcomes persisted over time, indicating that gray divorce operates as a chronic economic strain. Poverty levels among women old enough to qualify for Social Security retirement benefits are almost twice as high for women who divorced after age 50 as those who divorced before age 50. The same isn't true for men. Several demographic factors shaped the gray divorce phenomenon, researchers say. The American population is aging. People are staying healthy longer. Couples are marrying later, and fewer marriages last. Just 7.7% of all current marriages have reached the 50-year mark, The share of older couples who stay married for a half century is declining. In dollar terms, divorce is costly to anyone. Yet, for older Americans, the costs are steeper. "I haven't seen a scenario in which either partner is better off financially," said Elizabeth Windisch, a certified financial planner in Denver. "A man can expect his standard of living to decline by 21% after a gray divorce, according to research by Brown and her colleagues. A woman's standard of living will plunge by 45%. Both partners see their wealth decline by half. Women seem more likely to initiate a gray divorce," Brown said. "And women tend to fare worse after the parting, at least in financial terms. Women are more likely to take custody of the children, along with those costs. Women who divorce after 50 tend to have less work experience than their husbands, which means less potential for future earnings. Gray divorce can gut your retirement account, leaving you little or no time to rebuild. That might not sound so bad until you consider all the other expenses that come with divorce, finding new homes, shopping for new health insurance, paying legal bills. It's double the expense for pretty much everything," said Michelle, a certified financial planner in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Michelle represented a client who was divorced at 50. She was a high-level executive. Her husband was a stay-at-home dad. She had to give half of her 401k to him. "She has to pay him alimony," Michelle said. "It looks on paper like this woman makes a ton of money, but in reality, there's not a lot left." Michelle told her client her top priority should be getting her retirement plan back on track. That meant maxing out everything she can for retirement savings, diverting a larger share of her income into that diminished 401k. "She realizes she has a lot of work to do to catch up," Michelle said. "She leases a car every year. So, we've had the conversation, should you buy a car? Maybe I go on vacation in the United States instead of a tropical vacation." The client's oldest daughter is about to start college. Because of the mother's high salary, the daughter probably will pay full price wherever she enrolls. The client wants to send her daughter to a private institution. Crum counseled her instead to go public. Crum put it bluntly, if the daughter spends 4 years at a private college, the mother may have to delay her own retirement by that many years. "She originally said 62, Crum said. I said, we're probably looking at 65 or 67. Now, mother and daughter face a hard choice, returning to work after a long hiatus or not. The problem is it's harder to earn money after a divorce if you haven't worked in years. Figure out if you can live comfortably without returning to work, even if it means a tighter budget. A gray divorce can be especially daunting for an aging spouse who, decades earlier, gave up a career to raise a family. Patty, a certified financial planner in Birmingham, Alabama, worked with a client in her 50s, asked her husband of 3 decades for a divorce. The woman was living in her dream home, now an empty nest, counting the years to a prosperous retirement. "She had not worked in 25 years, I think," Black said. The woman soon realized she would never find a job with a salary that even approached what her husband earned. "We worked very hard to come up with a plan so that she didn't have to go back to work," Black said. "That meant giving up the dream home, buying a smaller one, and living on a reduced budget." Divorce poses a daunting schism at any age as one of life's most profound stressors. But for adults who split from their spouse later in life, the emotional and practical complexities can further stack up, mirroring their life experience. The creator of the heavens and the earth says, if a woman put away her husband, which is divorce, and marries another, she commits adultery. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, leave a like and a comment. And if it is your first time on the channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment, like, and share the video. Until next time.